The story of the Coens is just remarkable. Their growth in their observance of Judaism, and their dedication to Torah and to mitzvahs.
Tomer and Sandrine are incredible role models for all of us, who sacrifice, who selflessly are so devoted to their children to give them a Jewish education, themselves to lead such a richly observant, beautiful Torah Jewish life. They inspire all who know them to be able to reach for the stars and to be able to sacrifice in our own life to bring out the best in ourselves and our family.
Incredible parents, very dedicated people. You know, there's nothing they wouldn't do for their children. There's nothing they wouldn't do for the school.
Sandrine's dedication and Tomer was always seeking, really seeking for the truth and really seeking to do what's right. And when you meet him, you know he's the type of person that has integrity and is sincere.
He's a really nice guy, really sweet guy. You really got to get to know him. He's outgoing, friendly, always there when I need a hand.
He's a macher.
He's a big macher.
He's a very the biggest Sephardic macher in the community.
Tomer's the kind of person that you walk into a room and he just exudes energy, positivity, enthusiasm. You'll see him giving hugs to everyone he knows, and he's just a really warm, loving person.
Sandrine and Tomer are just very nice, friendly people. Sandrine was one of the first people who came to introduce herself to me when I was by my son's football game.
First one to turn to when there's a meal train. First one to turn to when there's chesed hours that need to be done. She's always there, she's always saying yes.
She's an amazing mom, so I can always, we're always the type that we switch kids out, I'll take your son, you take my son. She's just an amazing all around, great friend, great person.
6 years ago, I came to my wife and I gave her a pretty big to-do. I told her that this is the time. We need to keep Shabbat. We need to start raising our kids to keep Shabbat, teaching them about Shabbat. And it wasn't easy. It wasn't easy because we didn't have synagogue nearby. So for the first 2 months, we were living in pretty much anywhere we found a shul, we would spend the weekend. And the way that started is my wife would pack up everything for Shabbat. She would pack up food, she would pack up everything we needed to make Shabbat special. And that's the Mesirat Nefesh that she gave. And that was for our kids, that was for our family. That's why our kids are here today in Torah Academy. It's the reason we're here in this community.
What brought us here is Torah Academy. Our kids, we were traveling and it just, you know, got too much. They wanted to be part of that school community, to do Shabbos with their friends, you know, all the activities that happened. And, you know, we decided that that was the next move for our family.
Tomer and Sandrine, both of them really were embracing their Judaism and really wanted more for their children. And eventually, by their kids coming to Torah Academy, and them embracing more, they really wanted to be in a firm community.
Our kids teach us every day, constantly. You're doing this wrong, our teacher said this, we're doing that. Even though we have to we're Sephardic, we have a little different halachot, but you know, we balance it out.
We as parents try to teach our children, and our children also can teach us. So there's nothing more beautiful than that. And Torah Academy, the values that it's instilled in the Midot, is something that it's remarkable. We're grateful for the Rebbeim, we're grateful for the staff, the tremendous growth that our kids have experienced from the school, the nachas that we are able to see from our children. That is the reason that we are here today, because of Torah Academy.
If someone needs something done at Torah Academy, one of the first people we reach out to are the Coens.
You know, they're helping us shape them to who they are, so it's just my way of saying thank you. I'm actually blessed to have the time to be home, to have that extra time to help them, thanks to him.
Recently, Torah Academy was in need of construction on their bathrooms, and Tomer was the first person to jump on it and took it upon himself.
And he really stepped in and said, you know what, I'm gonna do this, I'm getting it done, that's it. He's that type of guy, I wanna do something, I'm gonna get it done, that's it, done.
He jumped right in. You know, he didn't ask, he saw a need, and literally his own sweat and time and efforts and resources over the summer, he took care for staff, for students, 4 different rooms, and it was quite an undertaking, but he really, and it's made a difference. And those are the kind of things that they do.
Tomer and Sandrine, we wish that you have continued nachas and simcha from your family, continue to grow in the path of Torah and mitzvos, continue to be an inspiration to all of us, and may we gather with you only for simchas in the future.